Numbers were hit hard by our closed border. But today the Prime Minister welcomed some of the first students to return. Kim Baker Wilson was there.
You can't.
In the suburb of Woolston. Some homes had to be evacuated as a result. Police are also asking anyone in the area who may have captured footage on their own CCTV cameras to come forward. The lucrative international student market is showing signs of post-COVID growth. Once our fourth biggest export earner worth $5 billion, numbers were hit hard by our closed border. But today the Prime Minister welcomed some of the first students to return. Kim Baker Wilson was there.
New country, new university, new Prime Minister. Emotions running high for these Japanese students welcomed by the PM.
Look, you could see that for many of them, coming to New Zealand had been something that they've worked towards for a long time.
Greeting some of the first students to arrive since the borders reopened.
5 days now, I suppose. I just came last Monday. Straight away, like on the first day and on the very first hour, perhaps.
Here's one of more than 3,000 student visa applications processed in the past month.
I just had goosebumps saying them all, like smiling.
Meeting new people, getting to know people from different backgrounds.
International student spending plunged 98% last year, $4.1 billion gone.
It won't be fully back to the levels it was pre-COVID-19 because it'll take several years to build towards that.
It's not a flood. It's not like everybody's banging down the doors and want to get back into New Zealand.
Those in the industry say growth in student numbers will depend largely on visa processing speeds.
We do have bottlenecks at Immigration New Zealand. And so that number may be challenged by the length it's taking to get the visas approved.
What we're seeing is a good number of them processed within that 10 to 20 working day period.
Today's small welcome, a big step towards trying to build the big numbers of pre-COVID times.
We know at this point in the process leading into the next academic year, our tertiary providers, our universities have 50% of the enrollments that they had pre-COVID.
All those institutions need those international students to make up budgets to fund new buildings.
As those now here start new lives in their new country. Kim Baker Wilson, One News.
The Prime Minister also says our